States for NAFTA negotiators, warning today he will only pull the plug on steel and aluminum tariffs if there's a new and fair North American free trade agreement. It is his latest salvo after putting the world on edge last week with his threat to put levies on those metals. And it comes at a crucial moment with Canada, Mexico, and the United States wrapping up the seventh round of trilateral talks today in Mexico City. He doesn't mind linking lots of different unrelated issues together if he thinks it gets him a better deal. I think he'll be surprised that it not only does it not get him a better deal in NAFTA with Canada and Mexico, but his tweeting and his rhetoric and his threats on steel and aluminum, for example, serve to galvanize, if you will, everybody that believes in the importance of free trade here in the North American neighborhood. Welcome to Business Day. I'm Kathy Murray. Much more than being a top line in a few moments. First, let's take a look at the headlines and the markets. Markets are rallying. U.S. stocks are erasing earlier losses as NAFTA talks wrap up and trade war fears create uncertainty. The sentiment, however, today, as you see this move higher, really boosted on House Speaker Ryan urging President Trump to reconsider his steel and aluminum proposal. However, President Trump is so far refusing to back down on planned tariffs. It seems as though the market is believing that the threat of tariffs will be less than feared. Let's take a look at the VIX right now. It is off the recent elevated levels, and today pulling back by about 6%, even off the highs of today. It seems as though the big money managers right now, what I'm hearing from traders, is that they are buying the market sell-off. They're also selling into some of the rallies. The bottom line, they do believe that the ultimate impact from a trade or tariffs will have little impact on rates or inflation. That is what the big fear was last week. The Canadian Federation of Independent Business is partnering with Chase to drive down American Express transaction costs. Under the terms of the deal, CFIB members will see the cost of processing an Amex transaction fall by as much as 50%. The deal opens the door for more small businesses to start accepting credit cards.
Headlines and Markets is brought to you by IA Clarington Investments. Choose high conviction active solutions from IA Clarington to navigate today's complex markets. Details at iaclarington.com.
Global automakers are still grappling with the response to Trump's steel and aluminum tariffs. The tariffs were announced just days before the year's first major international auto show in Geneva, Switzerland. And earlier today, I got reaction from Rolls-Royce's CEO, Torsten Müller-Ottfoss, about the tariffs. Let's take a listen.
Let me tell you one thing. Rolls-Royce Motor Cars is part of the BMW Group. And the BMW Group is a major investor in the United States, not only when it comes to manufacturing, but also generating lots of job cards in the United States and doing massively more business. So you could even say that the BMW Group brought already quite a lot of wealth into the United States. We as a group, we are fully interested in free trade worldwide, of course.
And while automakers and related parts manufacturers could be among those hit if U.S. President Trump follows through on his threat to impose stiff tariffs on imports of steel and aluminum, this tough talk only adds to the uncertainty that auto parts suppliers are already facing through NAFTA negotiations. Those companies, of course, include auto parts maker Martin.